So simple linear regression belongs to supervised machine learning algorithm, which means for regression problem statement, simple linear regression. I told you the simple linear regression will have one independent column and one dependent column. This is known as an independent and this is known as an dependent column. Okay, now I will pass values here, 1, 2, suppose 4, 10, 12, and okay, instead of this x1 x2, for a clear approach, what I will do is I will take column names as an x and y, then you'll have a clear idea. Okay, suppose the max behind, I'm telling the max behind simple linear regression, okay, max behind, complete max behind simple linear regression. Suppose I'm taking a column name as an x and another column name as an y. This x is nothing but an independent column and this y is nothing but an dependent column. Okay, I am passing some values inside x and y. Suppose I'm taking x values as 1, 2, 4, 10, 12, okay, and y I am taking as an 11, 21, 36, 54, and suppose I'm taking as an 82. Okay, 5 independent values are there and 5 dependent values are there. So first of all, we need to observe, for simple linear regression problem statement, the formula will be y is equal to mx plus c. Here y is nothing but an dependent feature and m is nothing but an coefficient and x is nothing but an values, which is known as an independent values. I'm writing very carefully here, independent, and c is nothing but an intercept. So first of all, we need to find out c and this coefficient value m. So for finding the, first of all, from these data, from x independent column and from y dependent column, we need to find out m, which means nothing but an coefficient. So how can we find out is, the formula for the m is x minus x bar y minus y bar divided by x minus x bar whole square. So here x is nothing but an each and every value, 1, 2, 4, 10, 12. So x bar means the mean of x. X bar means the mean of x. X, okay, the mean of x column. Okay, now what do you mean by mean here? Nothing but an average. Okay, nothing but an average. So what I'm doing here is I'm just rubbing it. I will keep the data set like that only on the left hand side, then you can see that and we can do mathematical implementation very, very clearly. So here mean is nothing but an finding the average. So how can we find out the average in real time? So each and every data point, the sum of each and every data point divided by number of data points. Okay, number of data points. I will show you the formula for the mean. Okay, first of all, we need to find out the mean value. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking m is equal to formula. M is equal to, which means not an m, mean formula is equal to summation of I is equal to 1 to n x of I divided by its sum of observations. How many observations are there? Number of observations. Okay, in theoretical, if you want, means summation of I is equal to 1 to n sum of observations divided by number of observations. Here, what do you mean by this summation I is equal to 1 to n? N means how many values are there? How many rows are there? Suppose we are having 5 rows are there here, 5 observations are there. I told you we will specify in data science, row is nothing but an observation and column in the name of features. Okay, don't get confused, both are same only. Now what I am doing here is summation of I is equal to 1 to n, which means according to this data, what I have taken, summation of I is equal to 1 to 5. Because how many observations are there? N is equal to number of observations. How many rows are there for me? 5 rows are there. So summation will be calculated from 1, summation I is equal to 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this will be the process, the max behind everything. I will see the implementation part, how we can do, how we can find out the mean and the intercept. Then we will see the gradient descent. The most important one is here gradient descent. Okay. So instead of that, I'm just rubbing everything. We'll take same values here. Some random values, no problem. Again, I'm writing data set here. X and Y. What I'm taking 1, 2, 4, 10, 12, here 21, 31, suppose 36, 42, and 82. Suppose this is the data I'm considering. I told you X bar is nothing but a mean. Okay, X bar is nothing but a mean of X, and Y bar is nothing but a mean of Y. So I want to find out the mean of X. So what is the formula? Mean formula, which means mean is nothing but an average. What is the average formula? I told you, summation of I is equal to 1 to n X of each and every data point, summation of each and every data point divided by n. How many rows are there? That many. So here for finding the X, I want to find out X bar here first of all. So 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 10 plus 12 divided by 5. So what will be the X bar for value? 1 plus 2 3, 3 plus 4 7, 7 plus 10 17, 17 plus 12 29 divided by 5. So what will be the value? Somehow it will be 5 point something. Suppose I am taking 5.4 approximately. Okay, suppose I am taking 5.4. okay, now Y bar, this is not a correct value, approximately I am taking Y bar. If you want to find out, you can go to the calculator, you can find out, no issue. Just understand the concept here. So Y bar means 21 plus 31 plus 36 plus 42 plus 82 divided by 5. Okay, after placing everything and dividing with sum, suppose I am taking value is 3, suppose random value I'm taking. If you want a correct value, you can do on your own, no problem. Just understand the concept here. X bar I'm taking, instead of taking 5.4, I can take only 5, suppose, for a better understanding. X bar I'm taking as an 5 and Y bar I'm taking as an 3. So here X is I'm taking as an 5 random value, suppose, just for example, and Y mean I'm taking as an 3. Now what I am doing here is the most important one. We want to find out the mean. We just find out the mean. We need to find out the coefficient and intercept. Why I am find out all this is when we are dealing with the gradient descent, all this comes to picture. Don't worry. Okay, all this comes to picture. I'm just now I will just find out the coefficient value. Coefficient value. Okay, now the coefficient formula in Y is equal to mx plus c. What I am doing here is I am finding out the m coefficient. M is equal to formula x minus x bar y minus y bar divided by x minus x bar whole square. Okay, here x is nothing but each and every data point, minus x bar is nothing but 1, 5. So 1 minus 5 plus 2 minus 5 plus 4 minus 5 plus, and other one is 10 minus 5 plus 12 minus 5 into only, no multiplication, into 21 minus 3 plus, and what is the next one, 31 minus 3 plus 36 minus 3 plus 42 minus 3 plus 82 minus 3 divided by x minus x bar whole square. Whatever the value we are getting here, x minus x bar in the first one, x minus x bar here, 1 minus 5 here, whatever the value we are getting, just apply root for that, which means square root. Suppose I am taking m value as an I am taking m value is equal to 4. After solving this approximate value, I am taking as an 4. What is our next step here? We need to find out the c. Now we need to find out the c value. This is most important. I am taking m is equal to, suppose our m value is nothing but m is equal to 4. Now c value. So in y is equal to mx plus c, I can find out like this. Now I can write the formula y minus mx. I just positive one, I just send to this side, is equal to opposite to is equal to say, then I am having y minus mx. Here y is nothing but a mean of y and x is nothing but a mean of x. So c is equal to 3 minus, what is m value? 4 into what is x value? 5. What will be the c value here? 5, 4 is 20. 20 minus 3 minus 20 is nothing but a minus 70. So this is how we will find out m value and c value. Okay, this is how we will find out the m value and c value. So here x bar is 5 and y bar is 3 and m bar is equal to 4 and c is equal to minus 17. But what is the purpose of finding all this stuff? Okay, what is the purpose of finding all this stuff is, I will tell you very clearly. This is where our machine learning comes to picture. Okay, so observe very carefully. Now what I am doing here is, now here y is equal to, what is the m value? 4. X minus, what is the c value? Minus 17 only. I am writing here m is equal to 4 and c is equal to minus 17. That only I am writing here. Now if you pass here in place of x, if you plus this values 1, 2, 4, 10, 12, what it will be? Y is equal to 4 into 1 minus 17. Y is equal to 4 into 2 minus 17. Y is equal to 4 into 4 minus 17. So y is equal to 4 into 10 minus 17 and y is equal to 4 into 12 minus 17. Okay, for this, what will be the value? Minus 13 and minus 9 here, minus 1 here. 40 minus 17, how much? Approximately I'm taking as in 23, I think, correct only. And 12 fours are, what is the 12 fours are? 48 minus 17 is 27, 37, 47, 31. Okay, these are the values. Okay, now here I will tell you one thing, the basic logic. I just prune the formula and theoretical stuff and max implementation, simple linear regression. But what is the purpose is, listen very carefully. Here x is an, I told you, independent. I am taken 1, 2, 4, 10, 12. Y dependent. Okay, what I have taken here? 21, 31, 36, 40 something, 48 something I taken, and 82. Here I get the mean value, x bar is equal to some 5, and here y bar something I get as an 3, and according to y is equal to mx plus c, m is equal to 4 I got, and c is equal to minus 17 I got. Till here okay, but after applying this values in y is equal to, what is the m value here? 4x minus 17. We will get another value. So I told you, no, just now I prune, that values are known as y hat, which means predicted values. Predicted values, the predicted by the machine learning algorithm. Till here it is the data. This entire is known as a data. This data we are given to the ML algorithm. Which algorithm we have given? Regression algorithm. In regression algorithm, we have given to the regression algorithm. It learns something from the data. It just gave me some values. That values I need to compare with the real values. Why we are finding out this prediction values means I need to find out the original values with the prediction values. So these are my original values, right? Now what is my prediction values? This I am taking as a prediction values. So if you pass this 1, 2, 4, 10, 12 in this formula, in which formula? Y is equal to what is the ML of 4x minus 17? You will get some values. Suppose I am taking as an 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose I am estimating it is a prediction value. If you want correct value, pass this 1, 2, 3 here and you will get proper output. Okay. Now this is an input. independent, this is a dependent, and this is nothing but a prediction. So we need to find out the difference between the actual point and predicted point. Okay, this we need to find out the difference between the actual point and predicted point. This difference is nothing but an residual. Residuals means nothing but an error. Okay, the graphical representation will be, I will show you very clearly, then we can go to gradient descent curve. Okay, the graphical representation will be, suppose if I am taking here this, I am taking as an x, sorry, this I am taking as an x, this I am taking as an y, with the help of, I am writing here with the help of matplotlib. In matplotlib I am using scatter plot. With the help of scatter plot I can decide, suppose I am taking, how many values we have passed in x, 5 values, and in y, first 5 values. Suppose in 1 2 4 10 12 I taken, but in y what I have taken, in y I have taken 21 31 46, something like 48, something like 82 approximately I'm taking. So we need to, first of all we need to plot the actual points. Suppose the actual points lying like this. Suppose I'm taking the actual points, which means x, y, y bar, which means it is predicted. This, according to this x values, I am plotting this y. First of all, in the red color, I am plotting x and y. So whenever there is an x value, there will be y value, no? Suppose I am plotting like this. So now what I am doing here is, I am plotting y predicted with the help of x, and y predicted values also I am predicting. So the values will be like this. Definitely the values will be like this in a straight line. Will come. We can prove that. No problem. When you are applying scatter plot, you can see. When you are, I told you, no, the code implementation also. I will tell you again. No problem. So the line will be in a straight line. This is nothing but, and if you want to this, see this line, just apply plot. Instead of scatter, you can apply plot. Okay. This black line is known as a predicted line. Predicted values. These red values are known as an actual values. So what we have to do? We need to find the difference between the error between actual point. Suppose this is an actual point I am finding. This is the predicted point. Now for this actual point and this predicted point, this actual point and this predicted point, this actual point, this predicted point, this actual point and this predicted point. So we need to find out the difference, which means error. Here also we need to find out the error. For these two values we want to find out the error. For this I want to find out the error. For this I want to find out the error. Suppose these two values I'm having an error is 2 I am taking, here I am taking 3, here I am taking 4, here I am taking 5, and here I am taking 6. So instead of finding an individual error, I can pass summation, no? Summation of I is equal to 1 to n, which means n number of errors. How many errors are there? That many. Now how can we find out the residual? I told you the residual formula will be, y minus y hat whole square. Okay, the residual formula is y minus y hat whole square. But this formula can be applied for only one data point. For example, for this point and for this point. What is the actual value here? The actual value will be this value, and the predicted value will be this value. What is the difference? If I pass y minus y hat whole square, I draw, the answer will be 2. Why this 2? I applied here, now the difference I already mentioned, 2. So instead of finding out individually, I will apply summation of I is equal to 1 to n. So for yi minus y hat I. So how the formula will become now? Summation of I is equal to 1 to n. Okay, just I am rubbing this, then you'll have a clear idea. What I'm doing here is I'm applying summation of I is equal to 1 to n y minus y hat whole square. Okay, y minus y hat whole square. How we can write this formula? Whatever the value we are having here and here. Okay, suppose I'm taking this value as 1 and this value as 10. So 1 minus 10 whole square plus these two points, everything. It goes on like this, plus. You will get one value by applying this mathematical stuff. You will get some one value. Suppose I am considering the value as 0.8. So 0.8 means 80%, no? Okay, 0.8 can be written as 8 by 10, no? Yes or no? If we go on above, it will become 0.8. Okay, 80%. 0.8 is nothing but an 80%. So the difference between the actual point and the actual point and the predicted point is 80%. It is very large. Okay, we need to reduce the error. Okay, we need to reduce the error. The error should be somewhere like 0.2, 0.1, like that. Okay. Actually, when we are dealing with code implementation, you can easily understood the theoretical stuff I am telling here. So if the error is large, if the actual point and the predicted point is large, the predictions will be not done properly. The accuracy will be not good. And whatever the predictions we are doing, that may be incorrect. Okay. For that purpose, what we will do, suppose here I am taking 80%. 80%. What do you mean by 80 here? The residual, the error is 80. Okay, it is too large because 80 is close to 100. Okay, 80 is close to 100. So it is very high. We need to reduce the error. Okay, we need to reduce the error. What error we have to reduce? The difference between the actual point and the predicted point should be very, very less. Somewhere the difference should be 0.1 or 0.2, like that, not 0.8 or 0.9. Okay, we need to reduce the error. So this till here, it is known as a linear regression algorithm. Okay, the reducing error, how we can reduce the error and how we can say this particular line is a best fit line. How we can say this line is a best fit line, how we can reduce the error is done with the help of a concept known as a gradient descent. Gradient descent. It is known as gradient descent is known as an optimization algorithm. Optimization algorithm. Okay, it is known as an optimization algorithm. For reducing the error, we will find out, we will use gradient descent for each